had a request to show the wattage draw on my 2020 MacBook Pro in the last video that I did while using an external monitor and with the lid open. So here are my tests that I ran. So the first one that you'll see is plugged into the wall, and I ran a Cinebench test because that seemed like one of the most taxing things I could do. And as you can see in this part, it looks like the most that it went up to was about 80 watts. And mostly it stayed at about 50 watts, which is what the graphics card will pull. And in the test with it running on battery power, it only got up to about 50 watts. It was actually less than that most of the time. I used iStat menu to do the test, and it didn't seem to update very quickly. So you'll see me click in and out of it over and over again just to make sure that you guys could see the update. The other test I ran, I actually ran Boot Camp, and through Windows, I used Afterburner and played Modern Warfare. This was all done with an external monitor hooked up as well, and on battery power, and then also plugged into the wall with the lid open on the laptop. And the thing that really surprised me about this is the wattage draw on it was a little bit higher. I think it got to like 46 watts when it was plugged into the wall is all, but when it was unplugged, it only went around the 30s. I don't think it even breached the 40 watt, and you'll see that in the video as well. I also wanted to share my viewpoint owning an Alienware before owning this MacBook Pro. I wanted to talk about a little bit about the pros and cons and why my opinion is that the MacBook Pro was a much better purchase and use of my money. So I'm not a big gamer, so the Alienware mainly is for gaming, of course, and that's why it has the RTX 2080. In one of the comments, I saw a comparison between the RTX 2060 and the 5600M that's in the MacBook Pro that I currently have. And I agree with that statement. The RTX 2080 was a much superior graphics card, but in retrospect, one of the issues I ran into is the MacBook Pro, I can actually continue to edit for, I think, up to 4 hours is what I did on battery life while the graphics card was in full use because I was doing 3D with that 50 watt. Now with the Alienware, even running menial tasks, I only got about an hour and 15 minutes of battery life out of it. Not to mention the fact that it would thermal throttle like crazy. Now, I'm not a big gamer, like I said, but I did play Modern Warfare on it. And during my gaming on Modern Warfare, because of the thermal throttling issues, I usually ran it 1080p with all the settings on high. But what would happen is as soon as the heat would get too much, the fans, of course, are extremely noisy, and I would start getting dropped frame rates, and I would have to adjust the settings in the middle of the game in order to maintain my frame rate, which was in the hundreds, so it is a very impressive card. But what I've noticed with the MacBook Pro, I haven't had to adjust any of the settings in order to maintain the frame rates that I like to have, and I have it set on 2K instead of the 1080p, and mostly the settings are on high. And the cool thing about that is it's predictable. So for me, if I were to choose the gaming option out of both of those, the MacBook Pro doesn't thermal throttle nearly as bad. At least when I was using it, it didn't heat up bad enough to thermal throttle. I'm sure it does. That's one of the major complaints of the MacBook Pro, so it definitely is something that comes up. But it didn't affect the gameplay, whether I was on battery or whether I was plugged in. And the fans are a little bit louder than the 5500M on the 5600M, but it also puts out a whole lot more performance. I think they touted about 75% of a performance increase, which is amazing that it can pump out that much more. And so this is obviously based on my own opinion. I would choose the MacBook Pro over the Alienware any day of the week, because for what I use it for, I get more out of it. I can run the battery, I can edit, and still get the same performance as I do if it's plugged into the wall, which is absolutely mind-blowing when you even look at the MacBook Pro being a gaming laptop, since that's what it's never been intended for. But using Boot Camp and Windows and the stock drivers that come with it, which is another thing, usually you have to get drivers that have been manufactured and tweaked by somebody else. I can't remember the website right now, but you can get those in order for it to run properly with the 5500M. But with the 5600M, I had no problems running the graphics on Modern Warfare. So it's a very, very cool option if you're in the market to get a new computer and you're trying to outweigh it like I was. Now, I know that Alienware did just barely put out the R3, which has the 2080 Super graphics card, which I'm sure is mind-blowing. With the RTX 2080 that I had in there, it was very, very impressive. In fact, with 3D design, it actually did extremely well. So on that end of it, it was great. Now, I was limited before with 16 gigabytes of RAM. I know I said that, but the new one has 32 gigs of RAM standard. So that may be an option for people. But for me, this is, you know, just based on my own opinion and my own usage. But I'm very impressed with the MacBook Pro.